Okay, so in this lecture, let's talk about scrolling down. That's one of the most important features which you need to know when you are working with mobile apps. Okay, so let's see where we would need that feature first of all in our API demos app. I would click on the demos and I'll click on views link here, and thereafter I want to scroll down to the point till I find this maybe web view or rating bar or pop-up menu. Okay, so basically scrolling down till you identify that element. So if you just come back by clicking on views, so and if you want to click the last option, that's not in visible mode, right? So script will fail. To make it first visible, you need to keep on scrolling. You need to scroll down till the last element, which is web view. Okay, so our test in this lecture is to scroll down till you see web view text. So how can you do that? Using Appium. Okay, so that we would try to learn in this lecture. So for that, let me create a new class for scrolling demo. And I would like to take the features from my previous class of capabilities. Good, so I can extend the base class. Extends base. Perfect. Now, so move my mouse and create. What's that? Okay. So B is small letter. Add throws declaration. Right. So firstly, you need to click on this views link as usual to reach this page, right? So we already have that in our previous lecture, how to click on views. So I don't want to waste the time. I would quickly grab that and use it in my scrolling demo class. Okay, so once you reach here with this step, you need to scroll down. So for that, there is one syntax in Appium. Okay, so this is okay. Before I show you that syntax, you can scroll down using Android methods only. Appium is not supporting any method for scrolling. Earlier there used to be a method called scroll driver dot sc. Now it's not there. So when they released initially and when I made this course, there is a method called scroll, but after few versions they depreciated it. So basically there is no direct method in Appium to scroll down to that specific method. So just like finding element with XPath, so you have direct methods, right? Even for swipe itself, you don't have a direct method, right? How did we swipe? We have used touch actions class and we are waiting and moving to specific element and realizing. So in the similar fashion, we need to bring down some strategy here for scrolling down, but driver dot scroll, something like that, you don't have in Appium. So you need to go with Android API only to scroll. Okay, so Android API is world in itself. So people, whoever has developed Android, so there's a lot of methods in Android to scroll down everything, because if there is no method, then there is no scrolling concept in Android platform. So definitely there will be some methodology to scroll down in Android API. So now in our test case, we need to bring that Android API into our Appium API to execute. Okay. So to execute Android APIs into our Appium API, you can do that using this driver dot. Remember, we have done in the UI automator test class, find element by UI automator. Yeah, find element by Android UI automator. Okay, just like we have done in our UI automator test. See that? So inside this, we are executing Android code. This is not at all Appium code. So you can execute Android code in your Appium test cases by providing this find element with an Android UI automator in that argument you can pass your Android code. And this is how we done, like test attribute value, and if you want to see clickable, scrollable or something, you need to give new UI selector dot and you need to provide these options. Just like, yeah, all these are, you see that scrollable and clickable, enabled, long clickable. So all these are properties of that location. So you can access this using new UI selector dot and that. So this is basically an Android code. It's independent of your Appium. So in the similar fashion, let me go to scrolling demo. Yeah, in this argument, I need to pass a code to scroll. And this is that code. Okay, new UI selector dot. So that is required, right? So we have learnt in our UI automator test that if you want to access some properties of scrollable, this is a property, or clickable, whatever, you need to say new UI selector dot and you need to write the code. And here also new UI selector dot, we are telling scroll into view. Okay, what does scroll into view means? Scroll into view is like we are scrolling into a text of view. So if I want to view that some text, I will keep on scrolling till I view that. Okay, so in this case, okay, let me copy, and so my text is what's my text? The last one. Let's select the last one. Oops, why it's not scrolling? So let me do slowly. Yeah, web view is my text. So I will give here web view. Okay. So that means UI selector dot scroll into till the web view text is visible. So till it is in a view mode, it will keep on scrolling. Okay. So to get access this method, you need to wrap that in UI scrollable class. You might be wondering, what is this UI scrollable class and why I need to wrap? This is just an Android code. So if you want to understand this, you need to understand the Android development. So for just scrollable, we are not going to learn an Android development, right? So the same trick which I have told in the UI automator test, just follow that. So if you want to access any properties, you would just say select new UI selector dot, scroll into view, and you need to provide attribute value, text attribute, to where you need to view. For this UI selector, we need to wrap it in UI scrollable class. Then only you will get access to this method. So it looks weird, but there is no option for us. You need to remember that. Okay, so let me go back to my scrolling demo. And I need to put that in double quotes. So if someone asks you to execute Android code into your Appium, just place that in find element by Android UI automator and pass that argument. Okay, it goes and performs that execution. So that's the tricky part here. Okay, let me explain you again, because I know this looks a little bit confused, but I'm just telling there is nothing difference between this test. If you are clear in the previous lecture, for all the properties accessing with selector dot, the same thing we are doing here, selector dot for scrolling, because you need to provide till what element I need to scroll. Scroll down till I see web view. Okay, so it's just argument, attribute, brackets, properties. That's how we define, right? So if you see UI automated test, attribute, brackets, value. So same thing, attribute, value, and you need to wrap it up in UI scrollable method. That's it. Now when you run this code, your test will keep on scrolling till it identifies web view. Okay, and once it is identified web view, scrolling stops, and then you can click on it, or it's up to you, whatever you perform operation. But if there is any test case like verify, are you able to scroll till you see this, then you should use this step. Let me run this test and show you. Click on OK. And go to Appium. Go back. This is the only tricky part in Appium, just scrollable. And now you see that it's scrolling down. It's not identified. Again, it's scrolling. It's not end fed. Scroll again. Now it's end fed. Stops there. So you see that 200 success. Okay. So till that web view is identified, it keeps on scrolling till the end. Now, let's say you don't want to scroll till the end. You want to stop whenever you see a radio group here. Okay. I don't want to go till web view. Just change to radio group. Now you are saying scroll down till I see that radio group text. Once you see that, stop there. So that's this test says. Okay, go back and stop the session and start again with hitting Appium. Run the test again, and this time it will not scroll till end. It should scroll till it identifies radio group text. Let's say that. You see that it started scrolling. It stopped because radio group is identified. It's not still scrolling down just like in the previous test. Okay, it stopped here as it is identified. So that's why we are saying scroll into view till that text, whatever you are passing, displays, right? So that's how you can scroll in Appium. So hope it is clear. Just remember this step and the way you do it. If someone asks to explain this step, just tell them that this is an Android API code we are executing inside this function. Okay. And this is not at all related to Appium. Okay. So that's it. In the next lecture, let's concentrate on drag and drop functionality. So how to drag an object in one place and drop in another place. Let's see that. Thank you.